Hello everyone, Shadefire here, and today I'm taking a first impressions look at the Stalin subway, also known as Metro 2. This is another one of those kind of weird Russian FPSs, but I'm hoping that, like a lot of them, despite all the bugs and everything, this game might have heart. Also, this pretty rocking title screen track here. This is actually one of those games I was going to track down a cheap box copy of, but then it came out on Steam, and after a bunch of launch problems where essentially the game was not in anyone's library who bought it, and a couple things I had to replace to get this to run, it is now playable. So let's get into a game here. Sure, we'll start on normal. Essentially, I had to download a fix from the Steam forums to actually get this to run. Because otherwise, it either wouldn't launch, it would crash on startup, or you get a black screen when you try to start a new game.
What does it bring you here?
Well, they said a library with trophy books is open nearby. I'd love to read them.
You'd better read Comrade Stalin's speeches, Dad.
Well, speeches.
Everybody does what he has to. You know, I'm an old intellectual. I've even seen the Tsar, studied at the Lyceum.
Sure. And I'm a scary KGB officer.
Sure. Well, I won't argue with you, scary Czechist.
Father, we're not Czechists. We're officers of the KGB.
I'm going to search for the library. Bye.
Bye.
Wait a second. Lena Lapina sent you her greetings. I think soon you will change your Czechist uniform to a bridegroom's outfit.
Ah, of course.
Well, a nice family. You're both Czechists. Her father, I think, also wears a uniform. Maybe you should make a proposal to her.
Dad, stop that. I joined the service to protect my homeland and not to search for a wife. Well, there's my train. I better be going.
Will you come around tonight?
Yeah.
Then see you tonight.
That's the sort of amazing voice acting I expect. Kind of weird that none of them even kind of sound Russian. Like, they're not even trying to do a bad Russian accent. They're just like, nah, we're just talking. I guess if they were actually Russian, they'd be speaking Russian in Russia. There was some dramatic music there for a sec, but then it stopped.
What happened?
They're arresting everyone.
Who?
What? Drop the bomb. I said, drop the bomb, bastard.
Okay, was that somebody else on the other line, or was that his dad telling him to drop the phone? What is wrong with the texture of that man's face? Oh, a bunch of men just appeared. What is that can? You can tell by the decals on the wall that this is the execution corner. I can't tell if music's supposed to be playing because it keeps cutting in.
Shoot them.
All right. Wow, what is this music? It's kind of great. I probably shouldn't murder these guys. These guys just look like civilians. And we're a good KGB. Were there ever such a thing? That looks like something I can pick up. No? It's not. Oh, that looks like health, but I think I'm at full health. Considering that thing at the top left is blinking. It's still blinking, though. I don't know how to make it stop. Oh, no. My health's at the bottom left. What is the top left, then? some like meter that is just constantly blinking. Alright, so we're a KGB. I guess we're being arrested by the KGB. Like those two there. I think the game might need some more audio. Let me turn it back up. Alright, that's better. That's not actually the game's fault. I just had the audio set about a third down. Because I thought it was going to be really loud, but then it turns out it's really quiet. That actually sounds surprisingly powerful for a Makarov. So of course, the other interesting thing for me about this game is that it obviously takes place in Metro 2, the sort of semi-legendary military branch of the Moscow Metro, which comes up quite a bit in Metro 2033 and Metro Last Light. Alright, so I'm guessing this hoodie guy is a civilian. He appears to be wearing a hood in addition to his sweater. Physics? Yes. Physics confirmed. I was trying to get him to examine his gun again. Alright, so these guys are all just like, man, I don't want any part of this. Our guy walks really weird. We like bob when we walk. So that's more health, I'm guessing. Which I still can't take. We also have armor. Alright, into the elevator we go.
The lifts are working here, at least.
I feel like with the head bob, it kind of looks like he's limping as he walks. Oh no. Or that guy. Who does not look like a KGB. Got ourselves a Simonov SKS. I feel like I'm not really sure when the SKS was a primary firearm in the Russian army. I'm guessing it's like late World War II, since early World War II was obviously the Mosin as their primary firearm. So yeah, I'm not really sure where it fits into Russian firearm hierarchy. Are we going up or down? We could go either. Nope, this door's locked, never mind. Oh, that's what that is. It's my objective thing. I guess it's blinking when it updates. Alright, we want to get out, so I guess we want to go up. All this great Cold War propaganda. Murder the shit out of this guy? Scientist lady? Who is apparently... I was gonna say, she almost looks like she's just completely naked under the lab coat. Aha. Health. Oh, we're already full again. I'd like jam that door into the shelf. More health, more health, more health. Excuse me, lady. I also read somewhere that there are... Oh, we can fucking dual-wield Makarovs. That's gotta be a first for most games. Hey, is that a KGB lady? What? Oh, I see. So, I actually was... As I was about to say, I read that this game has some pretty ridiculous, like, ricochet sort of modeling going on. So when I shot that guy, I hit that fucking bar and it bounced off and hit her in the face. Alright, let's see if we can get a drop on this guy. Oh, there's two of them in there.
Enemies are everywhere.
I like that you don't try to fire them one at a time, he just fires both every time you click. It just seems really silly. Oh, is that a PBSH? That's some KGB agent honor. What? I guess that just means it's interactable. Alright, so now we're heading to Moscow State University. I'm not sure if this is when it was first built, or it's just being renovated or something. For some reason, I assume those guys were civilians. Oh shit. Oh. This is one of those games where nothing happens when you die, you have to actually hit escape and load. Well, good thing I just saved. We don't have a lot of bullets left for the PBSH. I'm guessing he actually meant sweating and not swelling. So, if there's a lot of ricochet, I wonder if we can ricochet ourselves to death. Another hooded man. Oh, I almost shot that guy in the face. Thinking he was a... Yeah, who exactly are we fighting? Are we still fighting the KGB, or are we also fighting regular Russian soldiers now? I'm kind of unclear on what happened earlier on. Were they already having that conversation like that? Well, don't let me interrupt. This guy just doesn't even care. The walk sort of bobbing also makes me think that I'm like getting my feet stuck in the ground slightly every time I take a step. Like I'm struggling against mud or something. Damn it. So it seems like enemies are surprisingly resilient to body shots. And let me guess. Yep. Does the autosave do anything? Ah, it's also the beginning. Alright, let's skip ahead. Luckily, we have our old friend the quicksave to help out with this. There's a guy back here somewhere shooting me in the back. J Just position it right, and I missed. Unfortunately, it seems like enemies do not respond past a certain distance to your shots, so they'll just stand there until you can get a shot on them. Ow. Ow. Sniper up there. Alright, got Mr. Sniper this time. Weird, it seems like last time I got Tokarevs off these guys, and this time I didn't. Ooh, hello. PTRS-41. That's one Russian gun that never seems to appear in video games. Except maybe like Call of Duty World at War. It's basically a big-ass anti-tank rifle, and I have no idea why they have one here. I wonder if these can be broken. The answer is yes. And they have ammo in them. Oh, we did get to grab an SVT, though, not a... I think it's a TT-43 is the pistol I was thinking of. So, I'm noticing that for a game called the Stalin Subway, we are already not in the... Oh, jeez. Not in a subway anymore. They just do not give a shit about bullets to the chest. Alright, so I took care of those guys. Apparently I found a grenade, so hopefully that'll help with this little ambush here. Oh, sorry about that, civilian. I like that before I threw that grenade, he was just like, why? He knew it was coming. Oh my god, bunny hopping is so much faster. Seems like hiding and sneaking is a lot better than just running at them, because you just have to find a spot where they can't hit you and you can shoot them like this. Because they are, they're pretty crack shots. Now where are we? Oh, there comes a guy. Where are we actually going? There's a lot of my guys over there. Oh, sniper up there. Sniper-esque guy. Whew. There does seem to be a bit of a chronic lack of health kits, and especially armor. I don't think we found any armor at all yet. Now, enemies do drop health kits, but I think they're only 10 health, so they're not that... Oh, jeez. Not that great. I already got the guy up there. Oh, there's another one over there. He's down. Let's see. So it doesn't seem like a very mechanically complex shooter. Oh shit, how did you get behind me? He probably walked. What? I guess I was standing next to an exploding barrel. Yeah, it seems like the biggest appeal of this game is just to play a shooter with a lot of Russian guns in real-world Russian settings. Which, you know, Russian guns are neat. But aside from how much damage we take and how accurate enemies are, this doesn't seem like a particularly difficult game. Ah, there we go. Oh, that was a grenade, wasn't it? That's probably what killed me last time. Oh, jeez. Alright. What? He just, like, teleported back to his feet. Bullet to foot is not such a big deal. Is that a civilian? Doesn't look like a civilian. At least Russian civilians have the good sense to get down when shooting starts. Unlike most video game civilians are like, man, shooting, I'm just gonna stand up and run away. These four robbers are in a shootout with the cops? I better get up and just stroll through the middle of them. Ah, dear. There's a lot of guys in this one construction site. Nope, and that guy just fell over dead. You know, I think that's one of the first enemies in video games I've seen that can shoot under train cars. No. I'm sorry, hood guy. I thought you were a soldier. So yeah. This doesn't seem the worst thing ever. It seems like a, you know, silly fun little Russian FPS. Though I wonder how weird the plot gets later on. I guess we should use the PTRS on someone before we're done here. Alright, we found our lucky contestant. It looks like we can't move and shoot this thing, which makes sense, because it's pretty friggin' big. I love that he just exploded, like, actually exploded, not just, like, pink misted. Oh. So yeah, this is the Stalin subway. It is available for $4 on Steam, and you know, seems like a decent little romp. Maybe a bit enemy spammy here. Also, I've heard that there is actually a Stalin Subway 2, but it is sadly not on Steam yet. Also, don't know how much actual Subway there is in this game. A lot of mysteries in the Stalin Subway. Anyhow, I've been Shadefire, this is the Stalin Subway, and I will see you around some other time. Till then, you folks take care, and make sure to read your Lenin.